This video tutorial is provided by the College of Graduate Studies at UCF. In this video, I will provide an overview of Microsoft Word styles, demonstrate how to modify the normal style, and discuss how to create new styles for body text elements. Microsoft Word styles are used to tag text with a specific set of formatting attributes. These styles are used to create consistent formatting throughout the document, as well as to generate the required PDF bookmarks and linked table of contents. If you go to the Style section of the Home menu, you can click the small gray arrow in the bottom right corner to open the Styles window. If I select Show Preview, you can see how styles work together within the document to show different levels of emphasis within the document. The normal style is the default style for a document and is automatically used when you type within the document. When I first open a document, the font is set to Calibri 11 point, which is the normal style setting. However, if I manually change the font using the Home ribbon, these changes are not carried over to the normal style. For this reason, we ask that you first modify the normal style to reflect UCF ETD requirements and then apply it to the entire document. This ensures that all text will be formatted consistently and allows you to format any new text by applying the style rather than remembering to manually format the text. As the default style, normal also functions as the parent style for all other Word styles. Each style uses normal for its default settings, with whatever changes you make layered over it. If I set the normal style to Times New Roman and apply double spacing, the Heading 1 style will automatically incorporate the double spacing, but will keep its font as Cambria since it has already been modified. You will later use the Heading 1, 2, and 3 styles for your headings and subheadings. This ensures visual continuity between the different styles, and Word will use these styles to generate the table of contents, as explained in a later video. It is important that you modify the normal style to reflect your formatting preferences before using the heading styles or any other style created within Word. Before you modify the style, let's take a look at the UCF Thesis and Dissertation Manual requirements for body text. For a UCF ETD, the font should be a standard, easy-to-read typeface such as Arial, Courier New, Garamond, or Times New Roman. All text should be in a 12-point font, with chapter headings in a 12 to 14-point font. Tables and figures that are too large for one page may be placed in a 10-point font. If textual emphasis is necessary, use italics. Do not use bold or underlining. All manuscript text must be double-spaced, with the following exceptions: lengthy quotations of 40 words or more that result in block quotes, tables, table or figure titles, references, and headings or subheadings that span more than one line may be single-spaced. You may indicate paragraph breaks by either indenting the first line or aligning the paragraph flush left and adding extra space between paragraphs. Text may be either left aligned or justified. The first word of a paragraph should never be the last word on a page, and the last word of a paragraph should never be the first word on a new page. You can have Word manage this by using the Widow Orphan Control option. I'll show you how to implement these settings within the Word document. First, turn on the Show Hide All Formatting button to view any pre-existing formatting. Next, place your cursor in front of a section of body text. To use the normal style, you'll want to modify it first to ensure that it matches UCF ETD formatting requirements. To do so, go to the Styles section in the Home tab and click the small gray arrow in the bottom right corner. This will open the Styles window. Hover your cursor over Normal and click the arrow that appears to the right. From this drop-down menu, select Modify. Within this menu, you can set the font to any standard legible font that is recommended by your style guidelines. For this tutorial, I'm going to choose Times New Roman. I will also set the font size to 12 point. To ensure consistent spacing, click the Format button in the bottom left corner and select Paragraph from the drop-down menu. Here, you can change the line spacing to double and the space after to 0 point. If you prefer to indent the first line of each paragraph and wish to have this set within the style, you can change the indentation by selecting the drop-down menu under Special and select First Line, with the box by set to 1/2 inch. However, this will also be carried over to your headings and will push them 1/2 inch off-center. You can keep the setting as long as you remember to remove the indentation from your heading styles. Otherwise, we recommend manually inserting a tab at the beginning of each paragraph. Within the paragraph menu, you can also implement widow and orphan control. If you click the line and page breaks tab at the top of the menu, you'll see a box for widow orphan control. Make sure that this box is checked to ensure that word will prevent the first word of a paragraph from being the last word on a page, or the last word of a paragraph from being the first word on a new page. Click OK until you return to the document. Now, with your cursor in front of the body text, apply the normal style. If you have already emphasized or formatted portions of your document before applying the normal style, you will need to go back and reformat these selections after applying the normal style. For the exceptions to double-spaced text, such as block quotes, tables, table or figure titles, and references, you may manually implement such formatting by selecting the text and choosing single space from the paragraph menu. However, if these elements have specific formatting requirements, such as block quotes, you can create a new style and apply it to all occurrences to ensure consistent formatting. For this tutorial, I will create a new style to format any block quotes I may use within the document. Creating a new style will allow you to apply these formatting attributes every time you need a block quote, instead of manually formatting each block quote. To do so, go to the Style section of the Home tab and click the small gray arrow in the bottom right corner. This opens the Styles window. Here, click the button in the bottom left corner for New Style. Within this menu, you can name it according to its function, such as block quote. You may rename any new styles you create, but be careful not to rename the already existing heading styles names, such as Heading 1 and Heading 2, as this will cause your table of contents to not generate correctly later. Be sure that it is based on the normal style to maintain all other formatting consistent with the body text. You can then change the line spacing to single, indent the paragraph, and apply any additional formatting. This concludes the video tutorial for the normal style. If you have any further questions, please use the ETD help request form available through the Thesis and Dissertation Services website. In the next video, I will cover how to modify and apply heading styles.